Aloha bombshells and welcome back. I've been gone for a very long time, I know, but I'm sorry about that. My life has just been thrown upside down over the past few months, but it's for the better. I can't tell you anything about it yet. I want to, but I can't tell you anything yet. All will be revealed soon, I hope. I have a lot of brand new ideas that I want to get on this channel. Lots of new exciting types of videos coming up. I've really got a good vision for this Christmas. Christmas, that is weird. My last video I filmed, I think, was like May or June, something like that. And now we're in September, coming into October. What has gone on in that time? Jeez, time flies when you're having fun. Hey, I am back and I'm doing one of my favourite videos ever, I think, to watch and to film. It is, of course, the good old What's In My Bag tag. I love this one. I think the last one I filmed was about 6 months ago, but I've had this slipped up, it's so heavy. This said one for, I think I got this just before I went on my cruise, which was back in April. I started using it for a while and then I went to the one that I used on holiday, and then I've just been using this one ever since and I absolutely love it. It's from Primark and I've seen that they've got one now in there. It's got kind of a different design where this bit's kind of greyish rather than beige coloured, but I like this one. It's very heavy, there's quite a bit in here, so let's just crack on into the video. Any particular order at all. Just going to go straight into it, and as you can see, it holds a lot. It's going to pull this out, no particular order, and just see where we go. The first thing is my camera case. Very handy when you have a camera in the bag. I am daily vlogging, not daily vlogging, but weekly vlogging at the moment, so please head on over to my sister channel, More Retro Bombshell. Please do subscribe. And that you can catch up with everything over there. Charging lead, because my iPod's always dying on me. Headphones, just usual Apple ones. Always, actually, they normally are kept somewhere else, but they're in here. Royal Caribbean pen, love this. Memory from my holiday when I was away. I actually lost this one, I've got two. The other one's in here somewhere. Dad came out of the car this morning and he said, "I found a pen." I was like, "Oh yeah, where'd you find that?" And I was like, "I've been looking for this for ages because I knew I had two. I thought I lost it in transit when I was flying earlier this month, but I didn't." I've got it back and I'm happy. Probably the most exciting bit for you beauty gurus out there, my makeup bag. I actually used this as a clutch bag when I was on holiday, which you may have seen in the vlogs, but I got fed up of having my makeup all over in the bottom of my bag. So in here I've got the Zoella Kissy Missy lip balm, which I absolutely love. Great stuff. From All Wake Me Up mascara, love that one. My hair's getting in my way. Rimmel Stay Matte powder, again, love that one. So I've got to put that down there. I've got a compact mirror, which has got Marilyn Monroe on the front of it. Love that one. £1.50 from Primark. Eyeliner, just long black waterline eyeliner. This is a felt tip precision. My hair's getting all over the place. Precision felt tip liner in black. Love this one. Really, really good. Just a normal chapstick, because you know, winter's coming and it's getting colder out there and lips get chapped very easily. Got my portable charger in here actually, which needs to be on charge because it's dead. I used it a lot when I was travelling to Canada and back, and yeah, it's no good at the moment till it gets some light on it. Two lip products in here. This is the Rimmel 107, which I absolutely love. Haven't got it on today, but I love this one. One of my new favourites. Last year I didn't really see the hype in it, but I actually quite like it. and I've got the Collection Lip Butter in Perfect Plum. What's that? Sunglasses. Oh, I've actually changed these over. I've gone back to these ones. I've had more of these on holiday, which you've probably seen if you've watched my holiday vlogs. If you haven't, I will leave a link in the description box below. They're actually some of the best videos I've ever filmed, and one of them is really, really popular. Yes, so I've got these sunglasses. These are from Primark. Just handy little ones, because you know, the sun is still out. It might be getting cooler, but the sun's still out, and you need to protect your eyes. Now this is actually off of my old Primark purse that I loved, but it busted and the popper wouldn't come up. But this little bit sat in the back of it. So in here I just have a whole bunch of cards, my memory stick, and some spare memory cards as well. Always carry spare memory cards with me. Half open packet of soft mints, you know, got to carry some mints in your bag. A 3-pin plug. Okay. Wallet, purse, whatever you call it from wherever you are in the world. I love this one. I picked this up in Primark. This is one I got as a replacement, and I absolutely love it. Normally my purses get stacked full of receipts and things like that, but this one I've actually kept pretty clean. I'm absolutely brassic. I have no money except for, what have I got? $15 Canadian I've got left, which I don't actually see the point in exchanging, because I'm looking at going back again in the very near future. And I have a receipt for Superdrug, just as you do. And a whole heap of cards. Hairbrush with some hair ties on, which is actually very, probably needs to be hairy. But I always carry a hairbrush around with me now. You just never know when you're going to get caught out. Manicure set, which also goes with the mirror that was on the other one. And, my nail clip is missing. Okay, but yeah, on the inside, I think it was a couple of quid in the January sales in Primark. God, that was so long ago. I remember shopping for my holiday, it feels like so long ago already. I have some PS antibacterial, PS Love antibacterial hand gel. This is a Primark drubby, and it actually smells really nice. Ever so fruity and stuff like that. It's really nice stuff. Okay, I've got a Galaxy Duo cookies and cream bar. Don't know how that got in my bag, but it has. Oh, that you don't actually need to see. That's my bag jar from yesterday. And not one, but two diaries with me. Yeah, no me. Super organisational person. A little bit super organisational. That doesn't even sound right. Super organised person me, you know. Always uploading and things like that. Lies, all lies. But actually I've got half the stuff written in this one and half the stuff written in this one. And this one always, because I've got so many things I've got passwords for now. So I try and, I've written all my passwords, I shouldn't actually tell you this, but all my passwords are written down in here. Because I've got so many I get confused on which one's for which. But I try and prefer to carry this one down, so I'm in the process of swapping everything over and just carrying the one. I have my U3A melatonin brush that is unpopped, because I did the coffee morning with the girls the other morning, so I had to wear that. Another packet of mints, and an empty packet of mints. Really should clean my bag out more often. My camera charger lead gloves, because you know, I actually bought these the other day. We went to, I can't remember where we went to, but there's a new store in Southampton called B&M Bargains. Never been in there before. And we went in there, and there's actually really quite a lot of stuff in there. A lot of stuff for Christmas. I couldn't believe how much Christmas stuff they had out already. But I got these because I've got some somewhere else that were from Primark, and they had really nice like bits on the cuffs, but I don't know where they've gone, and it's starting to get quite chilly, and my hands get cold very easily, and then when I get cold I just can't warm up, so got to try and keep warm, so I have a whole heap of sweets and things in the bottom of my bag. They can come out. Level wrapper. Phone. This is the, I don't know, it's like Sony Xperia or something. I'm on contract, had it a couple of years. So that is the first, the main compartment empty. I've just got the little side pockets to go where I've got a car key, spare car key. No, I don't drive, but I keep my dad's spare car key. I've got my keys with my newly added Niagara Falls key ring, which I'm very happy about. My other Royal Caribbean pen, with the one that I know I had, and this came with my new diary I bought for next year the other day. And that's my friend's door key. The back pocket now. I have, this was actually my granddad's driving license. I always carry it around with me. But it's just got photos of me. Let's cover that up so you can't see it. Use a New Forest Academy thing. It's got a photo of me and my nephew. Is that my nephew? Yeah, that's my nephew at the top. I just carry family photos in that. Otherwise, it's just got a bunch of cards. That's my Bonfa badge that you've probably seen a thousand times before anyway. Passport. Very, very important for me in the future. I see a lot of airports and a lot of travelling for me. That's all I'm going to say. So I always keep my passport in here because if I put it anywhere else, I know for a fact that I will lose it. So passport stays in my bag. I have my NatWest little card reader thing, a little Lucky Charm bracelet. This was given to me by my brother and sister-in-law on my 16th birthday? Is it my 16th or my 18th? I can't remember. I think it might have been. I can't remember. It was either my 16th or my 18th birthday. They gave it to me and I've kept it in every bag since. This is a National Westminster Bank coin that someone related to me anyway collects coins that he gave me when he had loads of them. So they're kind of, that's kind of two things that I keep with me for luck, and they've never done me bad since. A lot has changed. I've become very lucky this year. I'm a very lucky woman. It all will be revealed as to why very soon. At the moment, can't say anything about it. That is it. My bag is empty. It's just this front pocket now, which before I bought this bag, or I didn't actually know that you could take this part out. Sounds silly, I know, but I didn't. And then when I did find out, it came in very handy when I went on the cruise because I kept my passport and all my little bits in there. I couldn't take it, I was going to use it when I went flying, but my handbag that I used wasn't quite big enough, so I couldn't use this as well. Otherwise I would have done, because it's so much easier. So in there I just have my charger, which is for my little power bank, which also fits my phone, and another pair of headphones. And then on the front, on here, this is going to be hard to show you, I have my little monkey that, monkey that my friend bought me in, where was it? It was the last port we visited, Vigo. Vigo, Virgo, I still never know how to pronounce it. And my little I Love Canada key ring. And my 21 key ring, which is somewhere along there, which I will have to take off next year because I won't be 21 anymore. And that is it. Everything in my bag. Wow. I really need to clean my bag out a lot more often because that was actually quite bad. I didn't realise I had so much. I actually want to try and downsize my bags a little bit because obviously I see a lot of travelling in my future, and taking a bag of that size around with me just does not coincide with that. So I think I'm going to downsize a little bit. I've got my eye on one, so I'm going to try and do that. It's going to be a challenge, but I'm going to try it. I didn't think I'd pack for 5 days in a carry-on, but I managed to do that, so anything's possible, you know? that is the end of this video. If you've enjoyed it, then please do give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to click the little subscribe button, which is down there, or there, I can never remember. And don't forget to head on over to my sister channel, More Retro Bombshell. Please do subscribe. I love you all, and I shall see you all in my next video. Bye!